In this video, you will learn about packages and imports. You will see how to declare packages or create packages. What are child packages? How to use imports and how we can import already existing classes into our application and use those classes. So let's get started. First, we are going to create a project in IntelliJ. So just go to File, New Project. Click Next. Next again, and we need to give a name to our project. I will call it packages and imports. So packages and imports, and just click fit. Now the IntelliJ window should appear. And let's go to SRC directory. That directory represents sources for our application. So source code will be always in SRC directory. Let's create a new package. So right click new package, and I will call it academy.learnprogramming. So academy dot, when you put dot in package name, it will create two packages. So it will create academy as one package and child pack learn programming. So academy.learnprogramming, and press OK. Now in source directory, we have two packages. Or we can say we have parent package and child package. Child package is learn programming in this case. There is also option in IntelliJ to compact empty middle packages. Since our academy package doesn't contain any code, we can select that option and it will compact empty middle packages. As you can see, it basically removes our package. And now we can already see that academy package is back. Now let's create a new Java class and call it import example. That class will be in learn programming package. As you can see, there is package declaration on top of the class. Sometimes on exam, they will not include packages or imports. So you need to be careful. If they don't ask about import, they usually remove the imports to save the space. So in that case, you will see some code that doesn't begin with line one. As you can see in IntelliJ, on line one, we always have package declaration. There is another thing that you will often see on exam questions, and that is again to save more space. They will merge code into one line, so it be confusing. Don't allow that code to confuse you. If the code is merged into one line, you can just rewrite it on paper, because on exam you will not have IntelliJ or any other IDE, you will just have paper and pencil. So sometimes it's a good idea to rewrite that code from the question on your paper and format nicely, especially if code is really hard to read or understand. So we have seen child packages. Now if we again compact empty middle packages, and if you go to packages, for example, you will see academy.learnprogramming. There is dot between. And if we click hide empty middle packages again, then we have empty package academy. Sometimes when you have a lot of classes, it is good idea to compact those empty middle packages. I will just go back to the project view. Now let's create our main class. So PSVM and pressing tab will generate our main class. And now we will use class random to generate a random number and to print that number. So random, you will notice that it shows you java.util, and that is the package where this class is declared. Automatically, when we press enter, IDE or IntelliJ in this case will import that class. As you can see, there is import java.util dot random. So util is child package inside Java package, and random is class that is declared in that util package. So random is equal to new random. And now we want to print the random number. So sout random dot next int. And let's put the bound to 5. Now if we run that code, you will get the output some number between 0 and 5. And as you can see, we got the number 3 printed to console. If you run it again, the number will be different, but the point here is we had to import our random class. On the exam, they might create packages with weird names, like A, B, C, D, for example. They might just have, for example, some package, and then A.B.C.D. So don't be surprised if you have some package names like that. That is normal on the exam. In real life, you probably don't want to create packages like that. Every package should have some meaningful name, so you know what is inside that package. What about system class? Why we didn't import system class? And how Java knows to use system class when it is not imported? Well, system class is in java.lang package, and the whole lang package is imported automatically. And that package is special because it's imported automatically, but our random class, it needs to be imported. As you can see, if you hover on system, you will notice there is java.lang, and that is the package where the system class is. There are also other classes in Java lang package. It's a good idea to remember just few, like system or, for example, integer. The wrapper is in Java lang package, and there are many other classes. So let's see if we try to import that class. Import java.lang, and you can see there is string, string builder, integer, system, and so on. So if we import system, we will not get any errors. But that import is just redundant. We don't need to import that package. We just need to import packages that are not in java.lang system. For example, if in package D, I create a new class, let's say my class, and now I want to import that class into import example application. I just need to do type my class, and you will notice it shows A, B, C, D as a package. So don't be confused if they even on exam add the import java.lang system. You shouldn't be confused by that. I will just remove it for the simplicity. Let's see what happens if we remove the package or the import declaration. If I comment out the import declaration, we will get compilation error. Cannot find or resolve symbol random. So Java can't find, or the compiler cannot find, our random class, and we need to import it. There is also star import. What is a star import? Instead of importing random, for example, we can import all classes in util package. So java.util. And you can see there are collection, arrays, and other classes. If we put star, that will import all the classes in that package. So we can use all the classes. Let's create in package D another class. For example, let's say example class. And now if we want to use both example class and my class, let's add my class. You will notice there is import ABCD my class. If we put star, and when we try to type example class, you will see that it automatically offers the example class, and we don't need to import anything. So don't be confused by that star import. Now we can remove that import. The other thing about imports is they need to be at top of the class or above class. You can't add import first and then package. That will give you compilation error. We will see other errors a bit later in this course and how to structure the code.